Welcome to the tutorial PowerXL DM1 Variable Frequency Drive Setup via Keypad. The following settings are to be done on the frequency inverter for an application. For example, the minimum frequency should be set to 20 Hz. The maximum frequency should not exceed 50 Hz. The acceleration time from 0 to 50 Hz should be 10 seconds. The deceleration time from 50 to 0 Hz should be 15 seconds. When the live bit drops out, for example from a PLC, a digital input is to be used to switch from remote control to local control. In local control, the start and stop keys on the keypad are used. The set point value is specified via internal reference value potentiometer. In remote control, the start/stop with clockwise rotation is specified via digital input. The set point is specified by an analog set point 0 to 10 volt using an external potentiometer via an analog input. When a new device is connected to the power supply for the first time, the startup wizard is started automatically. Note, here the operation of both the internal and the external keypad is shown in parallel. Only one of the two keypads is required for parameter input. With the DM1 Pro frequency inverter, the keypad is integrated. With the DM1 frequency inverter, the external DXG key LCD keypad can be used for parameter input. On the internal keypad, the first parameter is displayed directly. On the external keypad, the startup wizard is started with OK. First, you are asked whether the set parameters should be protected against unauthorized changes with a password. In our example, no password is used, so the down arrow key is pressed twice or the external unit is switched to the next parameter via OK. The minimum frequency shall be set to 20 Hz. To do this, press the right arrow key and then the left arrow key to set the 10th digit to 20. The entry is confirmed with OK for both operating units. Arrow left and arrow down are used to control the value of the maximum frequency on the internal keypad, which can also be seen on the external keypad. The following parameter P1.6 to P1.10 are for setting the motor data, which can be taken from the nameplate of the motor. The acceleration time is reduced from 20 seconds to 10 seconds in parameter P1.3 and confirmed with OK. The deceleration time is reduced from 20 seconds to 15 seconds in the next parameter, also confirmed with OK. The following two parameters do not have to be changed for remote control. They are already set to terminal operation and set point setting via analog input in the default settings. The keypad is not to be protected with a password in this example. A Bluetooth connection should also not be established, so this connection option remains disabled. If all parameters from the startup wizard have been run through, the call of the startup wizard is deactivated. If the wizard has been cancelled before, for example by the reset key, the wizard appears again the next time the DM1 is switched on. As a remedy, the startup wizard can be switched off via parameter P13.1.9. With the external keypad, it can be decided after completion of the startup wizard whether the parameters are to be stored in the keypad. The last step is to configure the DI3 digital input for the selection of local or remote control. To do this, go to menu P2 Inputs, submenu P2.2 Digital Input, and then to parameter P2.2.5 DI3 function. For pre-selection of remote control, the default value must be changed from 4 for external error to 19 for remote control. A short test of the configuration is performed. On the internal keypad, the output frequency is selected with M1.1 for the display. On the external keypad, multi-monitoring is selected. Here, a pre-configuration to output frequency, motor current and DC link voltage was made for the requirement of a typical commissioning. In local control, the DM1 is started with the green start key. The drive accelerates to the set minimum frequency of 20 Hz. The internal potentiometer of the keypad can now pre-select output frequencies between the maximum frequency of 50 Hz and the minimum frequency of 20 Hz. By pressing the red stop key, the output frequency is reduced to standstill. This is indicated on the external keypad by the flashing of the run LED and the run flag in the top left display. The digital input DI3 is used to switch to remote control. Here the start takes place via the digital input DI1. As in local control, the drive accelerates to the set minimum frequency of 20 Hz. Here, the output frequency range between the minimum frequency of 20 Hz and the maximum frequency of 50 Hz can also be pre-selected via the external potentiometer. To stop the DM1, the command is removed from the digital input DI1. Here too, the stop is performed with the ramp to standstill. If the digital input DI3 is removed during operation, the drive stops, although the command from the digital input DI1 for start write is still present. Thank you for your attention.